In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you always. As we come together to celebrate these sacred mysteries on this great eighth day of the octave of Easter, on Divine Mercy Sunday, let us call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you came to call sinners. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you heal the contrite. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. And on earth peace to people of good will. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. And on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
And let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast, kindle the faith of the people you have made your own. Increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. They devoted themselves to the teachings of the apostles and to the communal life, to the breaking of bread, and to the prayers. Awe came upon everyone, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their property and possessions and divide them among all according to each one's needs. Every day they devoted themselves to meeting together in the temple area and to the breaking of bread in their homes. They ate their meals with exaltation and sincerity of heart, praising God and enjoying favor with all the people. And every day the Lord added to their numbers those who were being saved. The word of the Lord. A reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in his great mercy gave us a new birth to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you by the power of God, our safeguard through faith, to a salvation that is ready to be revealed in the final time. In this you rejoice, although now, for a little while, you may have to suffer through various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that is perishable, even though tested by fire, may prove to be for praise and glory and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Although you have not seen him, you love him. Even though you do not see him now, yet believe in him. You rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy as you attain the goal of your faith, the salvation of souls. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. And the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. And Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As I said at the beginning of Mass, we are here on the eighth day of the octave of Easter. Easter Sunday is literally coming to a close today, and the Easter season will begin. And it doesn't seem too far-fetched or too mysterious
to imagine that it does begin with this great feast of divine mercy. And ultimately, that is what the gospel of Jesus Christ is about. It's about God's mercy upon all of us. And if there was ever a time and a place and a space and time, it is here and now that this world needs God's mercy more than ever. Not only mercy from our pandemic crisis, but mercy of all the other crises that have kind of got swept under the rug over the last 30 days because we haven't been together. They're still there, and they still will be there. But if we put our trust in God, because as Jesus says, we are not one of those who have seen and believe, but we are the people who are truly blessed because we have not seen and we believe. And we believe because of the eyewitnesses of these 12 men, of Mary Magdalene, of Mary, Jesus's mother. We believe through the centuries and the teachings of the church. We believe that in the beginning of time, when our biblical parents turned away from God, broke that bondage between God and man, wrecked humanity and God's relationship, and brought it all to an end, we believe that it was only God himself who could repair that damage. And that is why Jesus Christ came into the world, to suffer and to die and to be an expiation, a cleansing away, a wiping away, an erasing of that mistake of our biblical parents. And that is why we are called as a people, as a church, to be a people of mercy. Because all of our existence, all of our being, rests upon that divine mercy of God, stepping in and paying the price for our sins, of defeating sin and death and giving us a chance of eternal life, basking in God's glory. It is because of divine mercy that we have received that. And if we are expecting to receive that mercy, then we have to be an instrument thereof of that same mercy. We have to be God's mercy in the world. Whether we are dealing with our family members, our friends, our co-workers, even our enemies, even the strangers amongst the street, we are called to put on a face and a heart of mercy before all else. Because it is through mercy that forgiveness is given. It is through mercy that love is nourished. It is through mercy that hope is sparked. It is through mercy that faith is grown. The center and the source of all of this comes from the unbounding love of mercy God has for each and every one of us. Is it any wonder that he asks us to go out into the world and to preach the forgiveness of sins? He doesn't tell us to preach judgment. He doesn't tell us to preach condemnation. He doesn't tell us to preach separation. He tells us to preach forgiveness in mercy, to bring all peoples together, to allow all of us to understand that sometimes we all stumble and fail, but through God's grace, through God's mercy, we can get up and we can continue on that journey of life. So today, find someone that you can ask God to be merciful to. Maybe it's your children that you've been living with now for several weeks. Perhaps they need a little bit of God's mercy. Kids, maybe it's your parents. Maybe they're being a little overbearing. They could use a little bit of God's mercy. But on a more serious note, maybe it's your spouse. Maybe it's a coworker. Maybe it's a political rival. Maybe it's a stranger. Maybe it's a person of a different faith or a different religion, a different philosophy, a different way of life. Instead of asking God to get them, to smite them, to punish them, Ask God to be as merciful to them as we ask him to be as merciful to us.
Would everyone please stand? My dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask all of you, do you renounce Satan? And all his works.
I do.
And all his empty show.
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, the creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his divine grace in Christ Jesus our Lord. For he... And now, as a people of mercy, let us turn to our Heavenly Father, offer these petitions, and ask God to be merciful in answering them.
For the church, that is the body of the risen Christ here on earth, God's Holy Spirit may guide us in proclaiming the truth and hope of the resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace and justice in the world, may Easter grace be with all nations and peoples in turning away from division. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle each day to make ends meet, may God grant them a spirit of fortitude. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all here who have been reborn in the waters of baptism, or joined us at the table of the Lord this Easter season, may the risen Christ be their rock and their guide. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they share with the saints the reward of eternal joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the people of this parish, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, on this Divine Mercy Sunday, we offer our prayers to you. You know the prayers that we all hold in the silence of our hearts. In your mercy, answer them all according to your will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those you have brought to new birth, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Pius X, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence We rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you summoned before you, and in your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. For there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Now at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. And let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Why don't you take a load off and have a seat for a second, all right? Want to thank the cantor and the organist this morning. Want to thank our reader and our videographers as well. And I want to thank all of you all online out there who've joined us this morning. I hope you have a wonderful Divine Mercy Sunday. I hope you, as tomorrow begins, I hope you can enjoy the Easter season to its fullest potential, all right? Just a quick reminder, it has only been 31 days now since we have not celebrated public masses. It may seem like it's been forever, but it's only been 31 days. So this too shall pass. Let's stay home, let's stay isolated, and let's make sure that by doing nothing, we can make sure that we do everything right, okay? Now, it is the third weekend of the month, which means it's anniversary blessings. So if anybody was out there who was married in the month of April, please stand up, and the rest of us, let us raise hands over them, all right? Almighty and eternal God, you have so exalted the unbreakable bond of marriage that it has become the sacramental sign of your son's union with the church as his spouse. Look with favor on these couples whom you've united in marriage as they ask for your help and the protection of the Virgin Mary. They pray that in good times and in bad, they will grow in love for each other, that they will resolve to be of one heart in the bond of peace. Lord, in their struggles, let them rejoice that you are near to help them. In their needs, let them know that you are always there to rescue them. And in their joys, let them see that you truly are the source and completion of every happiness. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Congratulations, you guys. All right, everybody, have a great Sunday, have a great week, and if we don't catch you during the weekday masses this week, hopefully we'll catch you next weekend for our Sunday mass here at 9 o'clock. Take care, be healthy, be safe, and be distant. All right, and now if you would, everyone, please stand and bow your heads for God's blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give each of you gladness by his many blessings. Amen. May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make each of you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon each of you and remain with you forever. Go in peace, alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God, alleluia, alleluia.
This is